All right, so we are going to play some drums now, the fun part. This is a song from Godsmack called Straight Out of Line off the Faceless record. It's the first single off the record and first video. We made a video of this with Dean Carr, our good friend, and still my favorite Godsmack video. And it's a really cool beat, and incidentally, it was the first song that I ever wrote with Godsmack. When I first joined the band, I went and I auditioned in Boston, I got the gig, and we immediately started writing the Faceless record. And this was the first song that they showed me, and Tony Rombola showed me the guitar riff, and Sully said, "I want a tom groove," and then turned around and walked out of the room. So I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna write a tom groove. So I wanted it, the riff was a dark sounding riff, and the main thing that Tony wanted was for it to be really groovy, and then we're gonna stop and then blast into the big part, right? So I started with the hi-hat. Just got my hat on first. Started like that, and then it developed, you know, over as I continued to play it with Tony. It works in and out of the guitar thing. I made it a little more intricate as far as going to the second tom. At the time, actually, when I did it, I had tom one and tom two were over here. So it's a little bit more, it's a little different to play with my new setup. I put my right tom on the right side of my ride rather than two over here. So that said, the bell parts there match with the guitar. If you've listened to the Faceless record or the Four record or any of my past records, you'll notice that I play a lot to the guitar, and I really key off the rhythm guitar rather than, you know, a lot of drummers will key off the bass. I'm a guy that's always, for some reason, keyed off the rhythm guitar, and so I will follow a lot of what it does. And this groove, by the way, is also the verse groove. So it'll come into the big blast part and then break back down into the verse with this beat. I'll show you this beat again and then show you the variation that I do in the verse to break it up. Because also, you know, obviously you listen when you're coming up with a beat for a song, you kind of have where the verse and the chorus vocal is gonna go. So you also have to play accordingly. You don't want to be playing too much to where it steps on the vocal or whatever. So that's basically the intro, and then it goes into the big part and then the verse. So I'll play through those three parts a little slower than the way I do it on the record, and a little quieter too, so you can kind of get a vibe of what the kick drum is doing. That's the intro, and then we go into the big part, and that's where it explodes into the crash ride thing. And then basically, again, I just follow the rhythm guitar on this one. So it'll come in after the... Break that fill down. That was a cool fill that kind of came right off the top of my head there when we were writing this song. And again, though, it follows the guitar in a strange way. But it was something that came out that was really cool. But anyway, I'll break it down slow for you. I just went. So again, it was all. So fast is. And then the same groove in the verse. Now I'm gonna break this down real slow so that you can see exactly what I'm doing in the verse groove, which is the same as the intro groove with a variation in a fill that breaks up 2 and 4. So, wicked slow would be. In the mid-verse after 2, I break it up with a small fill. And then we go into the chorus. Basically, I go to the ride and just keep a groove again with the guitar. Just to recap, at the end of that chorus, it's 4. It's a quad on the kick drum into the fill. So. I'm gonna give this at medium speed here. Now we'll bring it up to full speed. Then we go back into the big part. Another verse, second verse, and then after the second verse, we go into a big chorus, and then we'll go into the middle eighth. And then with the middle eighth of this song, there's a little variation of it's basically like the tom groove, but then I just go to the hat. That's like when it's broken down there. So you're trying to create some kind of, you know, there's valleys and peaks in songs. And as the drummer, what you're really trying to do is create the mood. You're adding the feel to the song. And if you can show dynamics, then you're doing your job. So what I tried to do there was really break it down into a dark groove that was slightly different than the tom groove, you know, and And there's a cool little thing, too, on the show side that I like to do that usually freaks people out, but it's a real simple little thing. It's dropping your stick like this, but I go. So when I hit this hi-hat here, I throw the left hand to the hat, so then and then drop this stick like this. Put that on the hat and drop this stick. So I'll show it to you slow. It's almost harder to do slow, but it looks like this. It's cool. That's a little cool thing. And out of that then, big lead section, you know, I pretty much just filled off the top of my head. I don't even, a lot of times as you play a song 50, 60 times or whatever on a 2-year tour, you start to improvise a little bit and play things that were different, and you look back and or listen back to the record or hear the song on the radio, and you're, oh wow, you know, I play that part a little different, you know, and but that's a beautiful thing, I think, because obviously it keeps us from, you know, getting bored playing the same track, and it's always nice too because you come back to it later after making a new record or having some time off. And it makes you relearn your own song. So it's kind of cool. And it's kind of what I went through for this thing, because I haven't played the song in a long time. So it was cool being able to show this to you people and after having just relearned it myself. So anyway, with that said, after the middle eighth part, then the lead. The lead is basically just it's just a groove that follows the guitar. Then I go into a big monster fill. In a typical drum kit, all it is it's going down the line from the highest tom to the lowest tom. My kit set up pretty weird where my 10-inch tom's over here. So, and then I got the 12, 13, 14, 16. So the fill looks like this when I play it, but again, in a normal kit, you'll just be going do da da do da da do da da do da da do da do. But when I do it, it goes. So I'll show you how it looks slow. Take it up to speed, looks like this. Then we're gonna finish the lead out into the last chorus. We're out of there. Have fun.